My name is Lori Marsh, and I've been a member of Mount Sinai for 12 years. I am married to Marcellus Marsh. We've been married 12 years, and we have two boys, Mason, who's 6, and Luke, who is 4. My testimony is when we gave birth to Mason. Mason was born at 26 weeks, which was not expected and a little scary for both of us. I remember the day we went to the hospital because I had a discharge, and the doctor said that I'd have to stay in the hospital till he's born. I wasn't ready for that because the pregnancy was so easy, no morning sickness, everything was going along very well, and we were just excited for our first baby. So we get to the hospital and they say I have to stay there until he's born. I'm in the room and they won't let me do anything by myself, so the nurse is taking care of me the whole time. About 3 days later, I was hooked up to a monitor, and at one point, I think it was a Saturday, at one point Mason's heartbeat went down, and the nurse and the doctor came running in, and for about 10 seconds or so, it calmed down. So they found his heartbeat, he was doing okay. But they said if it happened again, they're going to take him. I waited till mid-afternoon, and Marcellus and I talked, and I still had more company coming in to visit. And then later on that evening, Mason's heartbeat went away again, and they said we have to take him now because we don't know why. So they take me into the emergency room, and they prep me. And Marcellus gets there, and he's in his grub and waiting. And they start cutting me open, and Marcellus is looking, and he looks at me, and I'm talking, telling him he came to visit today, and he's looking like she's cut open. How's she talking like this? But he couldn't feel anything. So they take Mason out. It was 10:13 that night, and they let Marcellus cut the cord, which they'd already cut because it was an emergency. And they let me kiss him, and I told him I loved him. At birth, Mason was a pound 14 ounce. He was one of the tiniest babies in the hospital. And, you know, they tell you the first 48 hours are extremely cautious, and they are making sure that he's doing okay. But I had a feeling he'd be okay, because when he came out, he gave a little cry. It was a soft cry, but it was a cry. On a mountaintop and tell. During this time, our church family was there for us, because the first person Marcellus called was our pastor at the time, H.B. Charles Jr., and he prayed. He prayed for Mason. He prayed for our family. And that led him to talk about it at church, and other people were praying for us. Pastor Hurt, at the time, was assistant pastor. He came to visit Mason 3 times in the hospital. Todd and Richie and Cassandra, and Phil and Lisa, and Tracy, and Anthony and Shanae, and I'm probably leaving somebody out, but I don't mean to. But there were so many people there for us, and they prayed, and they were so supportive. And if we didn't have that rock here with us, it would have been extremely difficult, because Marcellus and I both have family that are in Chicago, so it's us and our church family. And some friends, so it was a blessing to just be to get the hugs and the prayers and people asking, how are you doing, and taking care of us. It was a huge, huge blessing. Marcellus and I are so grateful to God for what He's provided for Mason. And one time when Cedar Sinai, that's where Mason was born, had a reunion for kids who were born in the NIC unit, Marcellus and I went. And we were excited to go. Maybe we'd see some parents that we'd seen in the unit and see some of the other kids. Well, we went, and it was a little sad because many of the kids that we saw were not, they had some issues that you could physically see. But we were so thankful that God did not let that happen to Mason. We were so thankful. I mean, we love Mason no matter what, but it's a blessing to have a happy, healthy child. It's a blessing that you just automatically expect, and it doesn't mean it's going to happen. So we were just ecstatic that so many people prayed for him, so many people loved him, the angels were around him, surrounding him daily. I know this, I know that. After Mason was born, Marcellus put a little video together, like in 10 hours, what he likes to do of Mason taking lots of pictures of him, and then he put the song, "No Weapon Formed Against Us Shall Prosper." So I had him put that on the CD for me, and every day, driving up La Cienega, going to the hospital, coming from the hospital, I'd play that song. And if it wasn't like a great day for Mason in the hospital, I would blast it in my car. Blast it, just driving down La Cienega and just singing the song, because I knew that God was watching over him.
Sometimes you just take my breath away. And it's too good to slip by. It's too good to lose. Too good to be there just to use. I'm gonna stand on a mountaintop and tell the news that you take my